what a great season he has had. They won in the Czech Republic. He was in pole position and finished second in Silverstone. A podium finish also for him in Germany. And I think those two fifth places in Aragon and Japan, just showing where he is now in the championship.
Yeah, he's had six top six finishes in the last nine Grand Prix, Cal Crutchlow. Only he and Marc Marquez decide to run that hard option Michelin front slick tyre in the warm-up session this morning. So it will be intriguing when the tyre warmers come off to see what Dylan can spot out there for us. We do think, as he said, everybody apart from Nicky Hayden on the Hondas running the hard option front.
And the two Suzukis at the moment also. We'll see. Here's Pol Espargaró. Three more races for the Tech 3 team before with his teammate Bradley Smith. They joined the new project in Grand Prix Racing, KTM. And actually, KTM will put a bike into that final Grand Prix of the season in Valencia, ridden by Mika Kallio.
There's a Hollywood actor, Eric Banner, of course, a massive, massive MotoGP fan. Seems pretty happy that the sun's shining today. He's well wrapped up from the elements, but great to see him down on the grid, soaking up the atmosphere ahead of this Australian Grand Prix.
As I said earlier, this crowd, they're amazing with the weather and everything else. They were treated to two unbelievable races in Moto 2 and Moto 3. And really, I think the early stages of this race are going to be something worth watching as the likes of Vinales, as the two factory Yamahas try to fight their way after Bayer qualifying. The worry, I think, where everybody is that Marc Marquez may clear off at the front. But Aleix Espargaró will be right behind him on the Suzuki, and he is in great form.
Yeah, he really is. Aleix Espargaró fancies his chances of a podium finish in this Grand Prix. He says the opening laps, the opening half of the race will be crazy and manic. Well, we certainly hope so. His last podium finish way back in Aragon in 2014 when he was on the forward Yamaha in that flag-to-flag race. We had that great fight over the line with Cal Crutchlow.
There is Andrea Dovizioso making his way back to the grid. The word is, and it's not official, that Andrea Iannone will return for the race in Malaysia next week. That's bad news for Mike Jones, who does such a brilliant job for the Avintia team. Hector Barbera stepping up, he's coming to replace him. And Jack Miller, first time he's raced in Australia since he became another Australian Grand Prix winner with that fantastic win in the rain in Assen.
Well, guys, I'm actually just down here on the grid with Jack. Jack, massive occasion for you, great qualifying today. What are you expecting for this race?
Yeah, it's going to be a long one, that's for sure. I mean, still unsure on about the tyre. You know, we put a tyre in that we don't actually have any laps on, except for the outlap I just did then. So it's a little bit strange. We've gone for a little bit harder compound, it's asymmetric. So it's going to be a special one, I think. We just got to see if it'll last the race. That's about it. You know, we hopefully the conditions don't get too much cooler and it stops working, but we'll definitely give it 100%.
Excellent. Thank you very much, Jack. Good luck.
Yeah, good luck to Jack Miller there. We saw Nicky Hayden with a good luck message to Danny Pedrosa. The word is there that he almost certainly will miss the race next week in Malaysia and probably be replaced by Hiroshi Oyama, who replaced him in the race in Japan.
Film star city down the grid there. We saw
Keanu
Reeves,
who we've
seen him a few times.
Here, Matt. Thought you'd be down there.
You've got your camera and your autograph book ready.
Stefan Bradl, what a good run he's on, and his teammate Alvaro Bautista. Stefan Bradl has qualified in eighth place despite a crash in free practice three. He's a best qualifying since Malaysia in 2014, best qualifying for Aprilia since Colin Edwards in Valencia, yes, in 2003.
Yeah, I've seen Colin Edwards knocking around the paddock working for British TV. Back to Dylan.
Yeah, guys, on the grid, but a little bit further back. I'm down here with Massimo Merigali from Yamaha. Mayo, slightly different situation for you guys this time. Quite far back on the grid, but a positive warm-up. What's the tactic going to be for those first laps? Very aggressive?
What do you think? For sure. As you know, if you lose even if our second to markets, is almost difficult to catch him, so they have to really push at the beginning, even if they have to think that the race is going to be long. But for me, there is only one strategy.
Of course, you guys have gone with the softer option front. The Hondas have now switched to this harder option front. Do you maybe think at the end of the race you might gain some advantage if it cools down a lot?
Yeah, first of all, Honda is used to use at least one harder step compared us. So the temperature compared this morning is not that higher. So we think that the choice we have done is good for us. Let's see what happens.
Thank you very much, Mayo.
Yeah, it's going to be an amazing opening few laps. Scott Redding, we saw then, has qualified on the fourth row of the grid, 11th fastest, 14th in the World Championship, third in Assen, that race that Jack Miller won, 9th in Japan last time out, and a couple of podium finishes here in Moto2, and 11th last year in MotoGP. Now, Jorge Lorenzo, Matt.
Yet down in 12th place on the grid, Jorge Lorenzo, the 29-year-old former MotoGP world champion now, of course. It's his worst qualifying performance since Assen in 2013, when he was also 12th on the grid. The last time Lorenzo was lower than 12th in a MotoGP race, you've got to go all the way back to his rookie year, 2008, in the Czech Republic in Brno.
Guys, well, I'm going to bring you down to someone who actually has qualified very well, Stefan Bradl. Stefan, good qualifying yesterday, but not just that. We're seeing the Aprilia getting stronger, you getting stronger. What can you realistically achieve today?
That's a good question, because we struggled a little bit too much, for my opinion, in the warm-up, because we had a lot of problems to bring heat into the tire. And, you know, it helps a little bit that the track temperature raised up a little bit, so that's good at least. But we'll see. To keep that position where, as we have now on the grid spot, will be not easy, as we have a lot of guys behind that are very strong and fighting for the championship. But anyway, I'll try to stay with them as long as I can, and then we will see. Trying to be in top 10 is a difficult target for me this weekend, but we'll try, we'll see.
Thank you very much, Stefan, good luck.
Yeah, very pensive looking Valentino Rossi on the grid. 15 podium finishes here in Phillip Island. 250 winner twice, 6 MotoGP wins, one just a couple of years ago. Second in the World Championship, just 14 points in front of his teammate, Jorge Lorenzo. It's a bitter battle for second place behind Marc Marquez.
14 points splitting the two factory Yamaha men, of course, who both crashed out of the Japanese Grand Prix just 1 week ago. That's why Marc Marquez comes into this Australian round as the new 2016 MotoGP World Champion. There's Andrej Dovizioso, so we said earlier, not a great record here in Australia, certainly in the Premier class. Just one podium, that was a third place in 2011.
Bradley Smith, third here 2 years ago, his first MotoGP podium, coming back from that horrendous injury in the endurance race in Germany. Out for 3 Grand Prix, returned in Japan and did a brilliant job to finish in 13th place. Recovered from a crash in qualifying 1 yesterday, and finds himself on a pretty tasty 5th row of the grid. You're on the 5th row, you don't expect Maverick Vinales and Valentino Rossi either side of you, really, do you?
No, not a usually customary appearance. Isn't seeing those two so far down.
So here we are, ladies and gentlemen. We're in Australia, round 16 of the MotoGP World Championship.
With golden soil and wealth for toil, our home is good by sea. Our land abounds in nature's gifts of beauty rich and rare. In history's page, let every stage advance Australia fair. In joyful strains and let us sing, advance Australia fair.
Thank you, Tanya George. We could only be in Australia, and we are getting closer and closer to the start of the 27-lap Grand Prix of Australia. Have a look now at Eugene Lafferty. He's had success here in other classes.
Yeah, he has, a 30-year-old Irish rider, 2 World Superbike wins and a World Supersport victory here in Phillip Island for Eugene Lafferty. His first DNF of the year last time out at the Twin Ring Motegi in Japan.
Yeah. Cruel luck, really, and he is going, of course, to the World Superbike Championship. He's returning to the World Superbike Championship. Be a big loss for MotoGP. He's had a fantastic season. Alongside him, another man that will be leaving the team, Yonny Hernandez, 22nd in the World Championship. Crash for him in qualifying 1, 12th in Japan, but he won't be with us next year.
Guys, let me just bring you down onto the grid one more time. I wanted a quick chat with Pol Espargaró, but he's in the zone at the moment, so I've grabbed Hervé Poncharel right next to him. Hervé, actually, big battle going on, Pol versus Cal for this top independent rider. What was your advice to him?
You know, it's so difficult to say anything before the race, because we know that we're on the front row because we were fast, but also because of the condition, and we were maybe a bit more lucky or more clever than some other guys. We know that three blue bikes, the two factory Yamaha and the factory Suzuki with Vinales, at least are going to come back and be in our group. So we will see. You know, Cal has been very, very strong. I would say that if you look at the whole weekend, Cal has been a bit faster than Paul. But, you know, race is always different. He has an incredible motivation. He wants to do a podium for the team before he's leaving for his new adventure. So let's see. But it's going to be exciting.
Thank you very much, Hervé.
Yeah, everybody tells us it's going to be exciting. Hervé Poncharal, team manager, of course, of Tech 3. We saw Mike Jones there, who's qualified in 19th place, and alongside him on the grid, Loris Baz, his teammate, also second in the World Superbike race here a couple of years ago, but a real injury hit season for him. And completing the grid, the former Moto2 world champion, it's Tito Rabat. Difficult one. I don't say it's a difficult one to call, Matt, at the front, but it's what's going to be happening behind is going to be very interesting indeed. And the tyre choice is interesting as well, isn't it?
Yeah, Aleix Espargaró and Jack Miller both going for that hard option front tyre. We suspected that the Honda riders might look at it after Cal Crutchlow and Marc Marquez used it in the morning session. Perhaps a surprise to see one of the Suzukis with Aleix Espargaró opting for that hard option front tyre.
I did find it interesting that Jack Miller said they had only tried it in the warm-up lap at this afternoon. He hadn't tried it before then. That's quite a gamble, isn't it?
Welcome to Japan. For the first time this season, Marc Marquez could win the world title. He's done it again, and Marquez almost wipes him.
Leads the Japanese Grand Prix. Valentino Rossi's crashed.
Oh, Lorenzo's down. That's it. It's game over. Marquez is the world champion.
Never say never in MotoGP.
What a move!
Yeah, who knows what is going to happen. One thing I think we do know, this man, number 93, the world champion 2016, will be a very, very hard man to beat. They are confirmation of the tyre choice. Marquez and Crutchlow are going for that harder option front tyre. Front row of the grid for the 27 lap race. It's Pol Espargaró in the middle of that front row. It's his second front row of the season to Cal Crutchlow, but in pole position for the seventh time this season, his 65th pole position. The man that clinched the 2016 world title 7 days ago in Japan, it's Marc Marquez. So welcome back to Phillip Island. I'm Nick Harris. Sitting alongside me, Matt Burt. Down in pit lane, Dylan Gray. And here is the grid for the 27-lap Australian Grand Prix.
65th pole position of Marc Marquez's career. He heads the front row from Cal Crutchlow and Pol Espargaró. Row two, Aleix Espargaró, Jack Miller and Danilo Petrucci.
Row three, Nicky Hayden, Stefan Bradl and Andrea Dovizioso. Round four, Hector Barbera, Scott Redding and Jorge Lorenzo.
Row five, believe it or not, yes, Maverick Vinales and Valentino Rossi, either side of Bradley Smith on the fifth row. Laverty, Hernandez and Bautista on row six. Row seven, Hector Barber's replacement, Mike Jones, the Australian in 19th, ahead of Loris Baz and former Moto2 world champion Tito Rabat.
Well, the long wait is over. The wind, the rain, the cold that everybody's endured over the last 2 days is long forgotten, because one more sighting lap, one more warm-up lap, and the 2016 Australian Grand Prix will be underway here in Phillip Island.
Well, it was an absolute classic 12 months ago. Are we about to see a repeat? It will be crucial for the spectacle. 36,500 fans who've seen, well, pretty much everything here this weekend, spring, summer, winter, autumn, and they've braved it here in Phillip Island, and hopefully they're going to be treated to an absolutely cracking 27-lap MotoGP race. Quickly down to Dylan. Dylan, it looks like it's only the Hondas and the Suzuki riders, bar Nicky Hayden, as you said, have gone for that hard option front tyre.
Absolutely correct. The only person to change back was Tito Rabat. Jack Miller made a very good point. It's only Cal Crutchlow and Marc Marquez who've actually tried that tyre properly. this morning, but they did show that it works. They did put in a very good pace, especially Marc Marquez, but of course they will have to keep an eye out if the temperatures drop towards the end of the race.
And weather-wise, Dylan, certainly looks like there's plenty of blue sky about. Oh, it's just the temperature that we're
in. It is by far the warmest these guys will have had. I mean, this morning was a lot colder. The wind was an awful lot colder. That's probably the biggest change we have now. The sun's been on the track for quite some time. So, you know, now are the best conditions to be going racing in. If it does change, I'll obviously keep you guys posted. But do bear in mind, we'll try and keep an eye out on the track temperature as the race progresses.
Many thanks, Dylan, down in pit lane. So here we go. The rain has stayed away. I think that's to the relief of everybody. Championship positions, well, it's all over at the front. Marquez is the world champion, but what a battle going on between Valentino Rossi and Jorge Lorenzo for second place in the championship. Teammates they may be, friends they are not. They will not be teammates next year.
Yeah, when you think about the likes of Jack Miller and the two Suzukis of Aleix Espargaró and Maverick Viñales gambling somewhat by running that hard option front tyre. They've only done what? The sighting lap and the warm-up lap on that tyre. They're basing that judgment on the pace that they saw this man, Marc Marquez, set in the warm-up this morning.
So here we go, front row of the grid. Marquez, Crutchlow and Pol Espargaró. What about people from that second row of the grid? To stop Marquez racing away at the front. Aleix Espargaró certainly capable of it. So here we go. The 2016 Australian Grand Prix. Three rounds to go of this incredible world championship here at Phillip Island.
Cal Crutchlow got away very well from the middle of that front row of the grid. Will Crutchlow get the run down to line? Pol Espargaró, though, will get the whole shot. What a start from third place by the Monster Yamaha Tech 3. Man, it's Pol Espargaró from Marc Marquez. Crutchlow's back in fourth place with Aleix Espargaró now up in a third.
Into the southern loop they come. So Pol Espargaró leads the way. Marquez closes up on him. Crutchlow in a big, big battle there for Aleix Espargaró through the southern loop up towards the Stoner corner. And Marquez very, very close. And Marquez perhaps fancies his chances at the hairpin on the very first lap.
Brilliant start by Danilo Petrucci on the Pramac Ducati. He's already picked up three spots into third. Jack Miller was looking up the inside of a couple of riders going into the hairpin. Marquez leads though at turn four.
Yeah, at the hairpin. You can see he was closing up and thinking about it. There is Danilo Petrucci. Aleix Espargaró. We then get a good view of Jack Miller behind his great mate, Cal Crutchlow. But Marquez leads the way. This is just not what the men that made bad qualifying wanted to happen.
Jorge Lorenzo's already up into ninth place. Rossi's picked up a couple of spots in the 13th. There was obviously a technical problem for Loris Bowers. He started the race from the pit lane. Down the hill into turn 10 for the first time. Marquez, Pol Espargaró, Aleix Espargaró has a look up the inside of Danilo Petrucci. He runs the Italian out a little bit wide, but Aleix Espargaró holds firm and takes third place. Crutchlow also sweeps through on Petrucci. He got picked up there, Petrucci, coming through turn 10 and lost two places.
So the two Espargaró brothers, the younger one in second place, the older one in third place, but for how long? Because Crutchlow now on the rear wheel of Suzuki as they come down towards the Doohan corner, first time round. Here is Aleix Espargaró. Here comes Crutchlow on the brakes. Dano Petrucci determined to get back on Aleix Espargaró, not able to do so. But Crutchlow moves up into third.
Dovizioso using the grunt and the slipstream of that Ducati to move by Jack Miller on the run down to the Doohan corner. So Dovizioso's up inside the top six. He holds firm on Miller through the southern loop. Marquez leads then from Pol Espargaró. Pol Espargaró led a Premier Class Grand Prix for the first time in his career on the early lap here.
Rossi in 14th place when they crossed, 13th place when they crossed the line, and Lorenzo in 8th.
Lorenzo's out horribly wide at turn number 4. He was trying to make a move on Jack Miller. He almost dropped back behind Nicky Hayden as well. So Lorenzo just perhaps getting a little bit impatient, struggling to stop that factory Yamaha with a full fuel tank going into that tight hairpin at turn 4.
Not a great start by Maverick Viñales. He was in 11th place when they crossed the line.
Loris Bowers has had to retire from this Grand Prix. He's certainly entered the pits. It's been a nightmare for the Frenchman.
Up over the top of Lukey Heights they come. Marquez at the front, Pol Espargaró, Cal Crutchlow, Aleix Espargaró, Petrucci.
Miller
and
fights
Jack
back.
Miller fights back against Andrea Dovizioso. Just runs it a little bit wide and Dovizioso retakes that sixth place.
Yeah, to make the move he had to just run in a fraction hotter. Andrea Dovizioso's too hot, too wise and too canny for that. Swept brilliantly back up the inside. Marc Marquez has already started to stretch the field out here at the front. Marquez comes over the line to complete lap number 2. A 1:33.24 for Marquez. His lead is already up to nearly 0.7 of a second.
Vinales and Rossi fight it out for 10th place as they go across the line. We arrive at Valentino Rossi closing up on Maverick Vinales. Fastest lap, 1:33.24 for Marc Márquez. It was the start that everybody dreaded, wasn't it?
Vinales was out way, way wide at the southern loop as he tried to find a way through on Nicky Hayden. Here's the two 2017 factory Yamaha teammates, Vinales and Rossi, having a pretty good fight. Confirmation there that Loris Baz is out of this Australian Grand Prix. Jack Miller was well, well wide coming through the stone, a corner there.
Here is Jack Miller through turn four, up towards Siberia. It's Jorge Lorenzo in front of him. Through Siberia they come. Rossi has got in front of Maverick Vinales and now closes up on his old teammate at Ducati. Nicky Hayden.
Marc Márquez now leads this Australian Grand Prix on lap number three by over a second. He's checking out the front of this race as the new world champion.
It's a good battle though between Hayden, Rossi and Vinales.
Guys, just to confirm, with Loris Baz, it was an electrical problem and his second bike wasn't ready as it was being converted to wet.
Yeah, Rossi threw on Hayden then at turn number 10. So Valentino Rossi up inside the top 10 for the first time in this race. I think Vinales also got through, Nick, didn't he, on that Nicky Hayden? So Nicky Hayden's getting a little bit beaten up in the early exchanges.
24 laps to go and Marc Márquez crosses the line. He crosses the line, the advantage almost 1.5 seconds.
Yeah, Márquez has already dipped into the 129s, a 129.830. Paul Espargaro's coming under real pressure here from Andrea Dovizioso. It's Cal Crutchlow in that third place on the LCR Honda. Good battle this for second place.
It is, because Aleix Espargaró is right behind Cal Crutchlow, so he's sandwiched between the two brothers. The younger one, Paul, chasing his first ever podium in a MotoGP. They close up for turn four, and they remain in station. We ride with Cal Crutchlow as they come up through Siberia. Marc Márquez is already through there. There is Andrea Dovizioso on Jorge Lorenzo.
Yeah, Rossi's through on Jack Miller. So Valentino Rossi's now up into eighth place. Maverick Vinales now all over the rear tyre of Jack Miller, the Australian, the 21-year-old. Looks like Cal Crutchlow was making a move on Paul Espargaró through turn number eight. Couldn't quite find a way through, but Crutchlow's ever so close. Is he close enough to attack the Tech 3 Yamaha man down into turn number 10? Not this time around.
Tries to pull back, but he's on the outside. Can he get up the inside at turn 11? Not an easy place to overtake, and Aleix Espargaró on his tail as well. That is two frighteningly fast left-handers that bring him onto the Gardiner straight. He's got up the inside, Crutchlow. Cal Crutchlow moved into second place. Can they slipstream him as they come down the Gardiner straight into the Doohan corner? And can Aleix Espargaró get through as well? Almost three abreast as they come into Doohan.
Last time around, Aleix Espargaró's gone into second place using the slipstream perfectly. On the last lap, Marc Márquez was a full second quicker than the rest of the field. He has long gone into the distance. Márquez leads this Australian Grand Prix by 2.5 seconds. He did a 1:29.8. No other rider as yet in this Grand Prix has been able to duck into the 1:29s. Paul Espargaró and Cal Crutchlow were a second off his pace.
Going to be a hell of a battle, though, for second place. Aleix Espargaró leads the way to turn four. We ride with Cal Crutchlow, Paul Espargaró right in there. Danilo Petrucci having a great ride. And Valentino Rossi is closing on them all the time. And we see Andrea Dovizioso running at the moment in sixth place. So Rossi has now actually got past Danilo Petrucci, I think.
Yeah, back with this battle for second place. It's Aleix Espargaró from Cal Crutchlow as they start the rise up through to Lukey Heights. Dovizioso's coming right back into podium contention here. The gap between Dovizioso in fifth and Valentino Rossi in sixth place is 1.4 seconds. Lorenzo's taken seventh back from Petrucci.
We ride with Cal Crutchlow. It was an audacious move on Paul Espargaró on the previous lap. Got up the inside as they came through that final corner into the Gardiner straight. Will he try it again? Here is Valentino Rossi. Rossi running in sixth place.
Márquez over the line then to complete lap number five. And again, he's in the high 129s, 129.916. Nobody able to get within 0.4 seconds of him. Crutchlow can't find a way through in the slipstream down to the Doohan corner. Nothing wrong with the top speed of that factory Suzuki.
I was going to say exactly the same thing. You'd bet your house on Crutchlow going through then out of the slipstream. He didn't get through. Through the southern loop they come. Named, of course, well, the next corner after Casey Stowe, the six times winner here. Great to see Dovizioso ride the Ducati through there. perhaps not quite in the same style as Casey Stoner is used to. On the brakes once again, Paul Espargaro closes up on Crutchlow. Crutchlow in turn closes up on Aleix Espargaro, but they remain in the same positions. And all the time, Dovizioso and particularly Valentino Rossi are closing. This is going to be a hell of a battle Maverick for second place.
Maverick Vinales just took seventh place from Jorge Lorenzo at turn number four. But the gap to Valentino Rossi is already up to almost a second. Last time around, Valentino Rossi was the second quickest rider on the track. He did a 1:30.087. That was just a tenth of a second behind Marquez. So Rossi's got podium pace, but starting from 15th, he just gave himself a mountain to climb. Crutchlow up in a second.
Yeah, at the bottom of the hill, turn 10, the old MG corner. Cal Crutchlow gets up the inside of Aleix Espargaro. Can he hang in there? We will find out through these two fast left-handers that bring him onto the start and finish straight. And Crutchlow has already opened up a little bit of an advantage on Aleix Espargaro. Marquez crosses the line, 21 laps to go.
Yeah, and his advantage is almost 3 seconds. We said about Valentino Rossi being the man on the charge. Well, Rossi's just dropped into the 129s. Rossi's just on the best lap of the race, so 129.795. So Valentino Rossi is coming right back into contention for this podium position. He's now just 0.7 seconds behind Andrea Dovizioso and Paul Espargaro, and he's closing rapidly coming out of the southern loop.
Yeah, Dovizioso has now got past Paul Espargaro, who led the way on that Tech 3 Yamaha through the Stoner corner. Crutchlow, Aleix Espargaro, Dovizioso, Rossi now right on the rear wheel of Paul Espargaro. We ride with Valentino Rossi.
Well, Rossi was a second a lap faster last time around than Paul Espargaro. He's going to make mincemeat of those guys in front of him if he can carry on with this rhythm, because Rossi is the fastest man on the track right now.
Run along the top end of the circuit through turns 8 and 9, then up over the rise, Lukey Heights. They plunge down towards turn 10. Is Rossi close enough to have a nibble at Paul Espargaro as they come down towards turn 10?
Yeah, you bet he is. Classic turn 10 move on the brakes by Valentino Rossi. Paul Espargaro's not giving it without a fight, but Rossi's through. Rossi then up into fifth place.
Now he's got Andrea Dovizioso on that factory Ducati on his side, through the two lefts, onto the Gardner straight. The man with the pace, the familiar number 46, Valentino Rossi. What would have happened if he had qualified better? Mark Marquez has disappeared. 2.8 seconds up on Cal Crutchlow.
Yeah, pace is hotting up. Cal Crutchlow's got nice temperature in that Michelin hard front tyre. He's just putting the best lap of the race, a 129.731, and Crutchlow is already starting to stretch away from Aleix Espargaro in third. The gap between the pair up to 0.7 seconds.
Well, we now ride with Andrea Dovizioso in his face, that familiar number 46. And now we ride with Valentino Rossi. They come through the Stoner corner, up towards turn four. The hairpin comes Rossi on the brakes, and he's got through on Dovizioso. Valentino Rossi has now moved up into fourth place.
Brilliant charge through the pack by Rossi. He started this Grand Prix in 15th place, his worst qualifying since 2011. Worst qualifying in 5 years for the Italian, but he's the man on the charge.
Brilliant stuff from Rossi.
He's 0.7 seconds behind Aleix Espargaro, but
we've
he's right
forgotten
in the group.
This man at the front, haven't we? Mark Marquez, the gap between him and Cal Crutchlow, 2.7 seconds. So Crutchlow has pulled back 0.1 seconds. But he looks pretty comfortable. His Crutchlow looks very comfortable in second place. But he'll be keeping an eye on the progress of Rossi, won't he? He was setting these fast laps. Well, Crutchlow has matched them now.
And these two will be very wary about a drop in temperatures. Mark Marquez was almost 5 seconds clear in 2014 when he crashed out of the Grand Prix. And Cal Crutchlow was running in second when he too crashed. So we know that the temperatures will drop. And those two, well, they know how they can be caught out. Cal Crutchlow's flying another fastest lap of the race, a 129.494. He was almost 0.4 seconds faster than Marc Marquez. The problem is, Marquez has been able to establish that lead of over 2 seconds, and you can't really see him surrendering it.
Now, you know that he can probably up the pace if he's got to. Rossi's picked off Dovizioso, he's picked off Paul Espargaro. Aleix Espargaro is next on the list of the doctor.
Yeah, and he's hunting him down. Rossi took 0.3 seconds outside of Aleix Espargaro on the last lap. Very, very close now to the Suzuki rider because they come out of turn number 5, head down to Siberia.
He'd love to get a little bit closer as they come over the top of Lukey Heights and plunge down to turn 10, the old MG corner. He did it to his brother Paul. Paul Espargaro fought back bravely, but Rossi was not going to budge, and he may have a go this time around.
Yeah, don't think he's going to be close enough. He carries great corner speed, though, through up through Lukey Hikes, does Rossi. Can't see him attacking from that far back now. There was no way through that Rossi could even think about a move on a later Spargo. That would have been way, way too ambitious. So he sits in fourth place right now, piling the pressure, though, on a later Spargo, who's still on course at the moment. Long way to go in this Australian Grand Prix. 18 and a bit laps to go. Aleix Espargaró still on course for his first ever factory Suzuki rostrum, but not quite sure for how much longer that's going to last.
Over the rise they come, then they plunge downhill. Rossi in the slipstream of the Suzuki pulls out side by side. Rossi moves into front of Aleix Espargaró into third place as they charge into the Doohan corner. Aleix Espargaró will fight back immediately, but Rossi holds the advantage through the southern loop.
Well, we know that Rossi's got the superior pace, so in theory now he should be able to break away pretty comfortably from Aleix Espargaró. We'll see what Aleix Espargaró's got in terms of a response. The gap to Rossi and Crutchlow in second place is 1.8 seconds. Oh, Marquez has crashed out of the Grand Prix, just as he did in 2014. Marquez has crashed out of the lead at turn number four.
Would you believe it? Marc Marquez out of the race, turn four. Twice in the last 3 years, he has crashed out of the lead. We look at the crash once again. Front end, I think, wasn't it?
Yeah, front end washing away. Ooh, it's a right-hander. It's a right-hander for Marc Marquez. That's what caught him out in 2014 as the temperatures dropped. The temperature, the right-hand side of that front tyre was cooled for Marc Marquez. He is down and out of the Australian Grand Prix. British rider Cal Crutchlow on the LCR Honda now leads by 1.8 seconds over Valentino Rossi.
Ah. Just when you think it's all over, it changes. This is going to be one hell of a fight between Crutchlow and Rossi. But he was using the harder option front tyre. Crutchlow is also on a harder option tyre. Crutchlow across the line, Rossi behind him. The gap, 1.9 seconds as we ride with Rossi into the Doohan right-hander.
And who won the Grand Prix here in 2014 when Marc Marquez crashed out of the lead?
Valentino Rossi.
And he's come from 15th place on the grid. The gap now, Crutchlow actually just took a tenth of a second out of Rossi, so it's 1.9 seconds. But that's the warning signs for these riders, Nick. They've seen Marc Marquez throw it down the road at turn number four. Dylan.
And I tell you what, guys, we haven't had sun for quite a few minutes now, and it's starting to feel a little bit cooler, so I wonder whether the track is just cooling a couple of degrees or so.
I can see Marc Marquez, he's standing watching the race unfold. He's just watching to see if anybody else goes down at turn number four, and he's now turned round to head back into the paddock. It's the first DNF of Marc Marquez's championship-winning career. He's been Mr. Consistency all the way through, but caught out by these slightly cooling conditions here in Phillip Island.
Rossi is slowly, very slowly but surely, pulling back the advantage of Cal Crutchlow at the front. He's pulled back 0.2 seconds. Here is Crutchlow at turn 10. Rossi already plunging down Lukey Heights.
Well, he's got time. 16 and a half laps to go for Rossi.
Take a big breath, everybody, because this is going to be something very, very special once again. And full marks to Crutchlow. He's pulled back a tenth on him through that third sector. But it is the worry of that tyre. We saw Lucio Ceccanello, the LCR team manager, former 125cc Grand Prix winner himself, looking up at the sky, checking just how the temperature was.
So can you believe it? Marc Marquez crashing out of the lead for the second time in 3 years here at Phillip Island. And Cal Crutchlow has managed to eke out a lead of over 2 seconds on Valentino Rossi now.
Let's tell you what else is going on. Keep looking at the screen, please, Matt. Alvaro, Aleix Espargaró third. Andrea Dovizioso four. Vinales five. Lorenzo six. Seven is Jorge Lorenzo. Eight, Scott Redding. Nine, Jack Miller. 10, Danilo Petrucci. 11, Nicky Hayden. 12, Hector Barber. 13, Stefan Bradl. 14, Bradley Smith. 15, Eugene Lafferty. 16, Yonny Hernandez. 17, Alvaro Bautista. Mike Jones going well in 18th place, and Tito Rabat in 19th. I think I missed out poor old Paul Espargaró there, running in 5th.
He is, but he's under real pressure from Maverick Vinales. We picked the two Spaniards up as they crest over the hill at Lukey Heights. Paul Espargaró desperately trying to defend. There's no way he can hold off Vinales. Vinales through then. That's 5th place for Maverick Vinales. He's come from 13th on the grid. I don't think that Vinales is going to get himself back into podium contention, though, but who knows? There's plenty of drama yet left yet in this Australian Grand Prix. Here's the race leader, Cal Crutchlow. Let's track him and the gap to Rossi over the line. Cal Crutchlow is still in those 129s, a 129.7 from Crutchlow. 2.4 seconds now is the gap.
Let's have a look at the start of the race. It was a great start by Pol Espargaró from the outside of that front row of the grid. There he is leading the way. Marquez into turn one, the doing corner in second place.
That was the start of Pol Espargaró's life. He must have dumped the clutch absolutely perfectly. On board with Maverick Viñales, riding around the outside of Hector Barbera. Pol Espargaró was almost 7, 8, 9 bike lengths clear of the field when they hit the brakes for doing corner.
14 and a half laps to go. Cal Crutchlow chasing just his second ever MotoGP victory. Here they are through the Casey Stoner corner, the Stoner corner, this fast, fast left. And Marquez closes right up on Espargaró, and he's going to get up the inside of him at turn four. But turn four proved to be his demise. That's where he crashed, and here he is walking back.
Yeah, speaking of demises, Marc Marquez then out of the Grand Prix, crashing out of the lead at turn number four. The first time he won't see the checkered flag this year. On board with him now. Tips it into turn four. That hard option front tyre, crying no more. Frustration and dejection for Marc Marquez. The world championship, of course, already safe in this pocket. But here comes Cal Crutchlow, who's doing a great job of trying to win for Honda here in Phillip Island.
Well, there's 14 laps to go. The gap.
Rossi's not making any impression at
all. None whatsoever. In fact, he's just losing about, lost about a tenth there, didn't he?
Crutchlow took another tenth out of him, yeah. Pol Espargaró's getting a bit of second wind chasing Maverick Viñales. He's just put in a personal best lap of the race at 130.484. This is the battle for third between Aleix Espargaró and Dovizioso. 0.4 between those two.
Back with Cal Crutchlow. It's a hard thing to say, it's for him to lose. But Rossi will keep that pressure up the whole time. Okay, at the moment, he is dropping back. But Rossi will push on and push on and push on. Crutchlow will not be thinking about that harder option front tyre that we won't say was caused the demise of Marc Marquez, but it certainly could have been something to do with it. We look at Rossi as they go over the top end of the circuit, past the old Hayshed corner, up over the rise, down to Lukey Heights. The gap, it's pretty standard. It's about 2.5 seconds at the moment as Crutchlow breaks for turn 10.
There's a really good six-rider battle going on for eighth place between Miller, Petrucci, Hayden, Redding and Barbara. Steffi Barber also involved as well. That's a really, really good dogfight going on for eighth place. Danilo Petrucci currently is running in eighth. He's just taken that spot from Jack Miller.
Well, here is Valentino Rossi onto the Gardner straight. See what the gap is when they cross the line. It's gone up another tenth of a second through the third sector. When they cross the line, it's going to be a long hold of 13 laps for Cal Crutchlow, but he's opened up the advantage to 2.8 seconds now.
This is really impressive from Cal Crutchlow because he's still inside those 129s and quite comfortably a 129.790. This is that exciting big battle going on for eighth place. It is Petrucci from Miller. Nicky Hayden doing a great job there inside the top 10. He's under pressure from Scott Redding. Well, that was Hector Barbera, very, very wide going through the Doohan corner. That's let Stefan Bradl through into 12th.
And there is Jack Miller. Game with that harder option tyre. The Suzuki's have also taken the harder option front tyre. Viñales and Aleix Espargaró are going very well at the moment. Aleix Espargaró running third. Maverick Viñales fighting his way through the field up into fifth place. This is Petrucci with Miller right behind him through turn four. Behind them you can see Nicky Hayden, that familiar number 69. Then Scott Redding.
Cal Crutchlow is pulling away. He's breaking Rossi, big style here. The lead now is up to over 3 seconds for the first time in the race. Live championship standings, it's all pretty immaterial in terms of the championship, of course.
But very still important though for second place in the championship.
Yeah. And Jorge Lorenzo struggling here. He's in seventh place. It's a very lonely seventh for Lorenzo. He's over 3 seconds behind Pol Espargaró and almost 6 seconds clear of Danilo Petrucci. Here's your race leader though, Cal Crutchlow, who was over 3 seconds clear of Rossi. Still in the 129s, Crutchlow last time around, 0.4 of a second faster than Rossi on that last lap.
There's absolutely nothing at the moment that Valentino Rossi can do. 12 laps to go, 3.3 seconds separate them. But in his battle for second place in the championship, it's good afternoon for him so far.
Well, it looked like the only man that could beat Marc Marquez in this race was Marc Marquez himself, and we saw what he did at turn number four. And now with a 3.3 second lead, it looks like the only man that might be able to beat Cal Crutchlow is Cal Crutchlow himself. This is at turn four where he crashed on the very last lap in 2014 when he was heading for second place on that factory Ducati.
Great picture of Cal Crutchlow through this Stoner corner, 225 kilometres an hour on that LCR Honda.
Jack Miller's back into eighth place. He's got ahead of Danilo Petrucci. Petrucci tries to fight straight back at turn number four. No way through, though.
We're back with Cal Crutchlow. We have 11 and a half laps to go. Dylan, weather-wise, there's a bit of blue sky about, certainly commentary box-wise. Perhaps even a little bit of sunshine.
None that we're really seeing from pit lane so much. Largely cloudy, guys. Do hold on, because we're just about to talk with Marc Marquez in a minute or so.
Many thanks. Please put in soon as you get to him. We ride with Valentino Rossi. I'm not saying he's settled for second place, but I think he feels that second place in 20 World Championship points when he started as far down the grid as he did on the fifth row of the grid would not be a bad afternoon's work. But this is a masterclass from Cal Crutchlow. Has this man grown into a really top-class Grand Prix rider?
Well, he's just taken another 0.7 of a second out of Crutchlow on lap number 16. The gap now is extended to 3.9 seconds. Rossi under no real pressure in second. Aleix Espargaró is almost 2 seconds further back in third place.
Petrucci crosses the line. Still a good battle with Hayden and Redding behind him. Jack Miller, as Matt said, is up into eighth place. Lorenzo running in seventh. Paul Espargaró in sixth.
You know, Aleix Espargaró can't shake off the attention of Andrea Dovizioso in that battle for the final podium spot. Maverick Viñales is edging ever closer to that battle for third. He's only 1.4 seconds behind Dovizioso now.
And then we had a good look there at Stefan Bradl on the Aprilia, also having a good ride. He's on the outside there.
Cool, brilliant by Nicky Hayden, not the inside of Redding and Jack Miller.
It looks like also that Scott Redding may have got through on Jack Miller as well. Dylan.
Guys, I'm just going to have to butt in. I'm down here with Marc Marquez. Now, Marc, such a shame you were leading by such a big margin. First of all, we need to ask, are you okay?
Yeah, I'm fine. First of all, I want to say sorry to the team because I did the mistake. I break too late and inside of goal, little bit wide. I try to keep the line and I lose the front. But I was taking a lot of risk for trying to push from the beginning. But in the end, we must to be happy because we won the title. But of course, we would like to win more races.
And you don't think that the harder front tire or the cool temperatures had anything to do with it?
No. This time was completely my mistake. During all the season, I was very careful on the breakpoints. DCP, I tried to forget. But, Michelin tires are always critical, but this time was not for the tire, was not a mistake, or it was just my mistake. So I want to say sorry to all my team.
Thank you very much, Marc.
Well, you can't be fair on that, can you, Matt?
No, self-inflicted then. Valentino Rossi's just made a mistake in the braking zone at turn number four. So Valentino Rossi just gifting more precious time to Cal Crutchlow. You can see there, Aleix Espargaró and Dovizioso. That gap's come down to Rossi after he made that mistake at turn number four.
Could that battle for second place suddenly become a battle with three riders? Can Aleix Espargaró and Andrea Dovizioso put some pressure on Valentino Rossi? Here you go, here is the mistake.
You just wonder whether Valentino Rossi, with that soft option front tyre, just abused it a bit too much as he tried to fight his way through from 15th place on the grid. Yeah, Marc Marquez pretty brutally honest as he always is. Of course, he's got himself into a position where he can take risks, throw a bit of caution to the wind, having already wrapped up the World Championship. So, yeah, big mistake, and it ends his perfect point-scoring record now in the MotoGP World Championship. How much time did Rossi lose then with that mistake at turn number four? Track him over the line now. And he lost a full second as Dovizioso takes turn from Aleix Espargaró. The Ducati man strikes, using the grunt of that Ducati down the garden straight. So Andrea Dovizioso now is leading the charge against Valentino Rossi. And Maverick Viñales is coming right back into this battle for third place. He's only 0.8 of a second now behind his teammate.
Will it be a battle for second place? Still well over eight laps to go as they come through the Stoner left-hander down towards the hairpin that was the demise of Marc Marquez. And we saw Valentino Rossi make a mistake there on the last lap. And Maverick Viñales is right on the rear wheel now of his teammate Aleix Espargaró. Battle for third at the moment. It could even be a battle for second.
Yeah, Vinales has got much the faster pace than the two riders ahead of him on track. Rumble with him powering out of Siberia. Last time around, Vinales was half a second faster than Dovizioso, 7/10 quicker than Aleix Espargaró.
Andrea Dovizioso, just one podium finish in the MotoGP class here at Phillip Island. Had a great ride in Japan where he finished in second place. Aleix Espargaró is certainly not letting it get away, but Maverick Vinales is closing on the pair of them very, very quickly indeed. Great onboard stuff with Dovizioso, with Aleix Espargaró, and he just got a glimpse there of the red number 25 of Maverick Vinales. Over the rise, onto the Gardner straight. Crutchlow has already crossed the line. Rossi across the line now. The gap, would you believe, 5.8 seconds between Crutchlow and Rossi.
Yeah, Rossi has regrouped after that mistake last time around at turn number four. Straight away, he was able to take 0.3 seconds back on this chasing group, which is now a three-rider fight for third place between Dovizioso and the two factory Suzukis of Aleix Espargaró and Maverick Vinales.
Through the southern loop they come up towards the Stoner corner. Two Suzukis beginning to hound the Ducati. Vinales, you fancy, might try and get through here at turn four. We ride with him. Two Suzukis run together. Aleix Espargaró will not give in and still holds on to a third place, a fourth place, sorry, as they chase Dovizioso and third.
Scott Redding's got himself to the front of that great battle going on for eighth place. He's got ahead of his teammate Petrucci, Miller, Hayden, Stefan Bradl, Hector Barber, and Bradley Smith's coming back into it as well. It's now a seven-rider fight for Ace, so great ride by Smith as Aleix Espargaró is lining up Dovizioso on the brakes at turn number 10. That's brilliantly done by Aleix Espargaró. He set that up superbly coming through Lukey Heights. Classic block pass at turn number 10, and Espargaró then back into third.
So sandwiched between the two Suzukis now, Andrea Dovizioso, Espargaró on the podium once again.
Cool, Dovizioso is nearly tripping Vinales up. Look at the corner speed through the final turn that that Suzuki carries compared to the Ducati.
But now it's the grunt of the Ducati. Can he get any sort of slipstream? And here comes Dovizioso. The Ducati just purrs past the Suzuki into the Doohan corner. So he's back into third place. Of course, what this is doing, it's not giving him the chance to get away, but keep that gap nice and easy for Valentino Rossi.
It's going to be so demoralising for when you're Aleix Espargaró. You've got to do all the hard work, take the risks in the corners to make the overtakes. And Andrea Dovizioso comes by like he's on a MotoGP bike and you're riding a Moto3 bike. The top speed of the Ducati is unbelievable. Here they go, then Aleix Espargaró through again at turn number four. And as Maverick Vinales also come through, he has, you know, not quite. Dovizioso fights back at Siberia.
Speedway there, wasn't he? Opened the door for his teammate as well, but full marks to Andrea Dovizioso. He didn't let Vinales through, but Aleix Espargaró back into third place. Vinales all over the rear wheel of the Ducati of Andrea Dovizioso. Up through turn eight they come, past the old hay shed, up to the top of Lukey Heights.
Espargaró has got to try and break away from Dovizioso to break the slipstream down the straight, because we've seen the Ducati will just blitz by him. It'll tear the blue paint off that Suzuki if he can get in the slipstream. Here is Rossi then, still in a fairly comfortable second place. Talking about comfortable, here's the race leader Cal Crutchlow, who's 5 seconds or more clear of the field.
Rossi crosses the line now. Here they come once again. Here comes the Ducati, and it just blasts past like a jumbo jet, like that plane that flew over here earlier, past the Suzuki of Aleix Espargaró. Yeah. He's back at him. He's like a terrier, isn't he? He's back at him straight away, and he retakes third place through the southern loop.
I mean, Aleix Espargaró coming out of the last corner onto the Gardner straight, they've got 7 or 8 bike lengths on Dovizioso coming out of that final corner, but it didn't matter. The grunt of the and the top speed of that Desmond Sedici GP machine is just far, far superior. Nothing Aleix Espargaró can do about it at all.
He's a difficult man to overtake on the brakes, isn't he, Andrea Dovizioso? Maverick Vinales really lined him up there at turn four, but he couldn't get by.
Look at the top speed of Dovizioso. He set the fastest top speed in this race. 340.3 kilometres, that's 211 miles an hour. Didn't even see the Suzukis in the top five on the speed charts. That's why Andrea Dovizioso can just wait till he gets on the guard on the straight, wind the power back on, open the throttle, and blitzed by Aleix Espargaró. He's coming under attack though from Maverick Viñales. Viñales safely through at turn number 10. That's nice by Viñales. He's now up in the fourth.
Well, they're going to try and make life a little bit more difficult. He's got two Suzukis to get past. When he blasts onto that front straight, there will be five laps to go when they cross the line. So Viñales now chasing after his teammate Aleix Espargaró. There is Dovizioso on the Ducati.
Yeah, Dovizioso, of course, is on that Michelin soft front tyre. Just wondering if he's running out of grip. Viñales, well, he's just picked off Andrea Dovizioso for fourth, and straight away he wastes no time in taking third place from his teammate Aleix Espargaró. He's a little bit wide at the doing corner, though. Aleix Espargaró will have the line. Will he at the southern loop? Yes, he does.
And the Ducati of Dovizioso closes right up on the pair of them. So they go into the doing corner. They're through the southern loop now. Coming out to the Stoner corner, will Viñales try and get up the inside on the brakes at turn four? He pulls across to the inside of the track. They're both on the brakes together. Here comes
Aleix
Espargaró's gone.
Carbon copy crash of the one that his brother had when he was fighting for the podium 2 years ago. Frustration and dejection for Aleix Espargaró. Down the road he goes at turn four.
And now there are two, and those two are fighting for that final place on the podium. It's Maverick Viñales and Andrea Dovizioso. What a great ride by Aleix Espargaró. What a brave ride. He didn't deserve to go down so close to the finish.
Yeah, he was pushing hard, was Aleix Espargaró. Just wonder whether maybe that was a temperature issue or whether he just got a little bit in that fraction too hot, grabbed the front brake on too hard, a little bit like Marc Marquez. He was breaking in quite a straight line with Aleix Espargaró when the front end washed out from underneath him.
This is Cal Crutchlow. He will cross the line. There will be four laps remaining. Can he secure his second ever Grand Prix victory? Rossi crosses the line. Well, it really is a case of just Crutchlow finishing the race, because he's 6.5 seconds up on Valentino Rossi. Can Viñales make any sort of impression on Valentino Rossi?
No, he's 2 seconds back. He's going to run out of time here, Viñales. The last time around, they both did 1:31.2s. Crutchlow still in those high 1:30s. It's not been just his speed for Cal Crutchlow. It's been his consistency. League of his own as he comes through turn number four on lap number 24.
Let's just have a little look down the field then. Obviously, that's the top four. Then fifth is Paul Espargaró, sixth Lorenzo, seventh Redding, eighth Petrucci, ninth Miller, tenth Hayden, 11th Bradle, 12th Barbara, 13th Smith, 14th Bautista, 15th Hernandez, in 16th place Lafferty, and Jones in 17th place. And Tito about to cross the line in 18th.
This is that seven rider fight as it is now, with Bradley Smith latched onto the back of this group, fighting for seventh place. It's Scott Redding still in the ascendancy. Nicky Hayden up the inside of Jack Miller at Siberia. So Hayden's into ninth.
Great to see that number 69 on the Repsol Honda bike, isn't it? Memories of 2006, of course, when Nicky Hayden won the world championship on the Repsol Honda. And a good ride, a brave ride again by Bradley Smith. Still recovering from that serious knee injury. Here is at the back of the group. There's Stefan Bradl in front of him.
Crutchlow, Rossi, Viñales and Dovizioso are already started their 25th lap. Lucio Cecina, you can see in that box at the top left-hand corner of your screen, you can barely watch. Crutchlow, 2 3/4 laps away from a famous win here in Phillip Island. Viñales did take a couple of tenths out of Rossi last time around, but Rossi's surely not going to give up a 1.9 second advantage with just three laps to run.
This is the battle for seventh place. We're back though with Maverick Viñales running in third. Can he close it down on Valentino Rossi? Time is running out for the 21-year-old Spaniard. He is a race winner here in Moto2, second in a Moto3 race as well. And you can see Rossi over his left shoulder as they come out of Siberia. Coming out of Siberia means there's 2.5 laps to go of this Australian Grand Prix. Yeah, it's just not pulling back. In fact, Rossi's just pulled back a tenth of a second on it.
Yeah, Maverick Viñales took too long to get into the podium hunt. A couple of great rides here, though, of course, with Rossi coming from 15th, Viñales 13th. They'll be ruining that qualifying yesterday, because they would have felt that they might have been able to have gone away with Cal Crutchlow and Marquez had they qualified a little bit higher up the grid. Crutchlow's about to come over and start the penultimate lap of the Australian Grand Prix, and he will do so. with a massive advantage. Hector Barbara's crashed out of that battle for seventh place. Barbara's down at Siberia, turn number six.
We arrive with Maverick Vinales. There is the gap, 1.5 seconds, 1.5 seconds, two laps to go. And there is Hector Barbara, of course, has ridden the factory Ducati for the last two races, replacing Andrea Iannone, and has crashed in the last two races, although he did get back on in Japan and finish the race.
Looks like Vinales has finally broken. Andrea Dovizioso is resolving that battle for third place. You can quite clearly see now that gap's increasing all the time. It's up to almost 0.8 seconds now between Vinales and Dovizioso. Crutchlow through Siberia then for the penultimate time.
1.5 laps left for Cal Crutchlow. Can he take his second ever Grand Prix victory on that LCR Honda? Valentino Rossi, what an amazing ride by him.
Oh, my heart was in my mouth there. I thought I saw a bite bit. Cal Crutchlow hasn't made a mistake. Oh, dearie me.
Here is Crutchlow. He is perfectly okay.
The old ticker skipped a beat there. Oh, Nicky Hayden's gone down at turn number four, and the way he's gesticulating, it looks like he might have got a helping hand from somebody, because Hayden's crashed out of ninth place at turn four.
This is Crutchlow running along through these two left-handers that bring them back into the start-finish straight. Nicky Hayden perfectly okay in that hectic old battle for seventh place. Could be a sad end, though, to his MotoGP career. Crutchlow, one lap to go before his second ever Grand Prix victory. Rossi should finish second. What a ride by the 37-year-old. Oh, it's Miller and Hayden involved in the incident at turn four.
Yeah, it was only Nicky Hayden, though, that crashed out. There's the Jorge Lorenzo in a very, very lonely sixth place. He is almost 20 seconds behind the race leader, Cal Crutchlow, who's already coming through the first sector. We can see Crutchlow out of that commentary position.
You remember 2 years ago, this is where he went down when he was running second in the race.
That could have been...
Takes a big, big breath, and he safely threw up to Siberia.
That had commentator curse written all over it, didn't it?
It did. And you'd have told him, wouldn't you?
Here's the incident between Miller and Hayden then at turn four. Yeah, Miller was in a fraction too hot. He had to run it a fraction wide, tangle with Hayden. Hayden came off the worst. Crutchlow then comes up through Lukey Heights. And Cal Crutchlow is heading for his second Grand Prix victory of the season. His second in the last six races. It was a long wait for British fans. 35 years since Barry Sheen won a Premier Class Grand Prix.
It's like a London bus. They're coming around every time you want them now after a 35-year wait. Into the Gardner corner for the last time. The 30-year-old Isle of Man resident, born in Coventry in England. Cal Crutchlow wins here in Australia.
Second place will go to Valentino Rossi, a brilliant charge through from 15th on the grid for the Italian. Maverick Vinales takes the final podium spot after he came from way down the grid in 13th place.
Fourth is Andrea Dovizioso, but he did drop back from that fight at the end.
Yeah, Pol Espargaró comes home in fifth position. Here's Jorge Lorenzo, a very, very lonely sixth place for the triple MotoGP world champion.
Now, who's going to win this battle for seventh place?
Scott Redding got it.
Oh, Bradley Smith up into eighth place on that last lap behind Scott Redding. Ninth, Danilo Petrucci. 10th, Jack Miller. And 11th place, Stefan Bradl.
Lucio Ciacinello struggling to contain his emotions as he gives the reaction immediately to the TV crews.
That was some performance by Cal Crutchlow.
Absolutely brilliant ride by Crutchlow.
Yeah, Czech Republic, he broke that 35-year-old curse on British racing by becoming the first British rider to win, and now he's repeated the dose here in Australia.
There was a bit of a security corner here at turn number four, but Cal Crutchlow just broken through it. Valentino Rossi's doing the same as well. They want to go and celebrate with the rest of the Australian fans. Valentino Rossi, though, is being ushered quickly back into the paddock. Cal Crutchlow just broke through the cordon and decided, well, you know what, this is only my second Grand Prix victory. I'm going to soak it up.
Here is Valentino Rossi and Maverick Vinales. Well, there's so many things to write about. Pol Espargaró coming up to shake hands with Maverick Vinales. One, the demise of Marquez. Two, the brilliance of Crutchlow. What a ride also by Valentino Rossi.
Here was Cal Crutchlow. Sweet, sweet feeling then for the British rider. Celebrating in front of almost 37,000 Australian fans. He never looked really in any doubt, did he? Once Marc Marquez had crashed out of the lead at turn number four, Cal Crutchlow had it absolutely, completely in control.
He certainly did. I mean, we thought Rossi, once he got through the people in front of him, would start to close, but absolutely not. Lucio Ceccanello is in there somewhere. Boys, he put some hard work into that team. Back into pit lane, back into Parc Fermé. Cal Crutchlow, a two times MotoGP winner. I think there's going to be some celebrations in here. Here he comes.
What a couple of months it's been for Cal Crutchlow. Became a father for the first time, of course, with the birth of his daughter Willow. And now, as Nick said, he's a two-time MotoGP winner.
Boy, that was some win. Yeah, Marc Marquez crashed out, but he absolutely devastated the opposition, didn't he? He flattened them. Great ride by Valentino Rossi into second place, and he has opened up that advantage over Jorge Lorenzo in their battle for second place in the championship. Been a tough old weekend for the 37-year-old, qualified 15th, but finishes in second place. Equally impressive, he'd be there somewhere. Maverick Vinales, who qualified in 13th place and put the Suzuki on the final position on the podium in third spot. There we go, Fada Union Jack, that's good to see.
Well, Union Jack flag and a Valentino Rossi woolly hat as well, so they'll be pretty happy with the outcome of today's race.
Hasn't got Suzuki shoes on. Brilliant race. Congratulations to Cal Crutchlow. I think he said when I saw Rossi, I won't say the next bit, but he intimated that he thought, oh my God, he's going to close up on me. He didn't, because Crutchlow rode the race of his life at the front.
It usually is panic stations when you see VR46 on your pit board, but he had it measured, perfectly controlled. Great ride by Cal Crutchlow.
It's a glimpse there, Luca Cadalora, the race coach to a Valentino Rossi. I think Vinales is in there somewhere, is he? It's a tight old Parc Fermé. It's a very tight pit lane at Phillip Island. Great race. And Marc Marquez catching everybody by surprise. They're going down at turn four. But Crutchlow taking the opportunity he got with both hands.
Valentino Rossi's 20th Australian Grand Prix, and that's his 16th podium finish. And he did it all from 15th place on the grid.
So Cal Crutchlow, race winner in the Czech Republic, race winner here at Phillip Island, and still two more races to go. Lucio Ceccanello, I don't think you can actually believe what has happened the second half of this season.
Well, Cal Crutchlow is now back into sixth place in the World Championship as well, courtesy of that victory.
Oh, there he is, a big hug there from Maverick Vinales, who also rode a brilliant race into third place after qualifying on the fifth row of the grid. Don't forget, Vinales and Rossi both came from the fifth row. Crutchlow did start in the middle of the front row. Well, the weather held firm. Three unbelievable races here at Phillip Island. And not too much time to celebrate. Everybody on the plane and flying to Malaysia for the penultimate round of the championship in Sepang in front of a sellout crowd next weekend. Let's hope they're as richly entertained as the people here at Phillip Island. You get the feeling they will be. So here, Maverick Vinales, fifth row of the grid, third place. He talks to Dylan.
Well, Maverick, congratulations. Your second podium in a row, from 13th to third position on the podium. But tell us, just how tough was that battle at the end, especially with Aleix and with Dobby?
Yeah, it was so difficult because I come to Aleix and Dobby so fast. Then I tried to overtake, and it was so difficult to overtake Dobby. After, I don't know, I give my best. I'm sorry for Aleix that he crashed. Honestly, I hope that he's okay. But really happy. Thank you to the team, because we make a really difficult choice in the front. And finally, we bring back at home 16 points, so it's so good.
Thanks a lot, Maverick. Congratulations.
Yeah, Cal Crutchlow will take all the headlines, rightly so, followed by Valentino Rossi. But Vinales, great ride from 13th place on the grid to take a podium finish here in Australia. Next up probably will be Valentino Rossi. What a ride for 15th place on the grid. They found something in the morning warm-up, but did they find what we expected? Well, an awful lot more, one would say. And Rossi now comfortably leads that battle for second place in the World Championship. So Valentino Rossi is making his way to talk to Dylan after a brilliant second place.
Well, Valentino, congratulations from 15th on the grid to second place. A very exciting race. But tell us, when you got past and you saw Cal, did you think, right, I can now catch him?
Yeah, you know, this morning we discovered that we have a good pace with a good condition. And step by step, I come back. At the beginning of the race, the first lap was very funny. And I hope to go to Cal, but today he was too fast, he was too strong. So congratulations to him, and thanks to all my team, to all the guys, that we did a great job.
Thanks a lot, Valentino. Congratulations.
Second place for Valentino Rossi, the race winner, Cal Crutchlow. And here we are, Rossi making his way through the field. That's the move on Nicky Hayden. So Nicky Hayden, he takes next one on the list, Paul Espargaro. At the bottom of the hill, the old MG corner. Who's next on the doctor's waiting list? We're about to find out. It's Andrea Dovizioso. Tick out the next one. Down the Gardner straight into the Doohan corner, past Alessio Spargaro. So second place for Valentino Rossi, but the day belongs to the 30-year-old Cal Crutchlow, his second Grand Prix win with Dylan.
Well, Cal, congratulations. You have won your second ever MotoGP race, and in actually quite dominant fashion. But tell us, was there any kind of doubt in your head when you saw Marquez crash out in front with that same harder front tyre?
Yeah, I was terrified. I broke really, really weak into that corner for the whole race. I knew it was critical, towards the end of the race. I crashed there two years ago when I had 10 seconds behind me also, so... Yeah, I was quite scared, to be honest, with that, and I didn't want to make the same mistake, but I knew I had to keep pushing or else we lost the heat in the front tyre. I was quite confident I could have maybe caught Mark, but when he crashed, I just thought, what do I do? So I carried on trying to keep the same pace, and then the last 10, 12 laps, I didn't really push. I just made sure I kept the heat in the front tyre. I pushed on the laps when the sun came out, when the sun was in, because then I knew I needed to heat the front tyre. When the sun came out, I was a little bit more relaxed. So I know it sounds completely strange, but this is Phillip Island. You never know what's going to happen. But I'm really pleased for my team. The LCR Honda team has done a great job this weekend. I was confident I could have won, with Mark in the race. But Honda have done a good job with our bike. There's no doubt about that. And we now look forward to the last two races and see what happens for next year.
Thanks, Locale. Congratulations.
Congratulations to Cal Crutchlow, his second Grand Prix win, back into sixth place in the championship. And sounds like it's a pretty good tactical nous going on there when the sun went in, just to push on a little bit to keep the heat in that harder front tyre.
Yeah, we're reliably informed that Cal Crutchlow is the first British rider to win two races in a single season in the premier class of World Championship racing since Barry Sheen, way, way back in 1979.
Oh, there you go. Yeah. So, Barry, he'll be up there somewhere. He'll be pleased about that. He'll be looking down, talking about Siberia and everywhere else, and thoroughly enjoying himself. Oh, what a weekend we've had. The weather, the wind, and everything else. Three great races. But the star of the show in MotoGP is the 30-year-old British rider. He's lives on the Isle of Man now, but he does come from Coventry in the Midlands, riding that LCR Honda, Cal Crutchlow. And what happens to his future, as he so rightly said? Two more races to the end of the season, and then next season, who knows? Because Cal Crutchlow is hot, hot property. So the riders making their way up the steps. Valentino Rossi and Cal Crutchlow are still having a good old chat. And we heard Crutchlow say to him, didn't we? When I saw it was Rossi second, I thought, here we go. And Rossi himself said, I thought I could close up on him. But Crutchlow was in a league of his own here. And there's the big moment. Turn four, leading by a country mile, and Marc Márquez goes down. And to his credit says, total rider error. So we are preparing to come out on the podium. And the little door opens on the side. Who's going to be first out? One would imagine it, well, we'll wait and see. We won't guess. So here we go. LCR Honda, their second Grand Prix victory in the premier class for Cal Crutchlow. Maverick Viñales in third place on that X-Star Suzuki. In second place, Valentino Rossi on the Movistar Yamaha. But the race winner here in Australia, his second only Grand Prix victory, it's Cal Crutchlow. There is Lucio Ceccanello, far end. He's put so much effort into this team. Of course, running 250s. Casey Stoner riding for them also in the 250 and the MotoGP class. Cal Crutchlow signing for them a couple of years ago, and it's bearing fruit with two Grand Prix victories now. Congratulations to LCR Honda. An independent team wins once again. In second place, from 13th place on the grid. Another great ride by the man that joins Yamaha next season, but this was on the Suzuki, Maverick Viñales. In second place, from 15th place on the grid. Six times winner here in the MotoGP class. He did win here a couple of years ago. This was right up with his great rides, Valentino Rossi. But we have a new man making his way in MotoGP, his second Grand Prix victory. It's Cal Crutchlow. Congratulations to Cal Crutchlow. Congratulations to the LCR Honda team. Commiserations to Marc Márquez, but as he said, he already has that world championship in his pocket. The Carver flows. I'm sure a little drop of the amber nectar will flow here this evening. All three riders absolutely delighted for different reasons. Rossi coming from 15th place, Viñales from 13th place. They really couldn't hope for any more. And Crutchlow, the middle of that front row, and riding like a champion when Márquez crashed out. Photograph time. Already the teams will be